experience and the joy that we get when we take time to pray. And Daniel understood the significance. He understood that his power came from his Father in heaven. And Daniel prayed 3 times a day. And as you listen to this song, I'd like to encourage you, if you can, as a matter of fact, we all can, it doesn't matter where we are, get in the practice of praying 3 times a day. And you'll be amazed at how it draws you closer to Jesus. Evening and morning, and anew will I pray and cry aloud. And he shall hear my voice, and he shall hear my voice. Evening and morning, and anew will I pray and cry aloud. And he shall hear my voice, and he shall hear my voice. In the morning when I rise, when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus. Dark midnight was my cry. Dark midnight was my cry. Dark midnight was my cry. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Just about the break of day, just about break of day, just about the break of day, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Jesus, you can have all this world, but give me Jesus. And when I come to die, when I come to die, when I come to die, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world. Have all this world. You can have all And it's sort of my story, and I think it could be the story of a few people sitting in here. God takes battered, broken people, and He makes something out of them. This song actually is about a violin. It's about a violin that was built by the master's hand. And when it was made, because God doesn't make junk, God makes all things beautiful, doesn't He? And that was His plan for us. But because of sin, people have been hurt. People have been damaged. I remember traveling in the trains in New York City, and the trains in New York City are about two blocks long. So if you get on the train at one end and you know your destination, you know where you're going, you can walk through the train, and where it finally stops, you can be that much closer when you get off to where you intend to go. So oftentimes people walk from train to train, going through car to car, I should say, to get to the other side of the train. I remember doing this when I lived there, and the trains can be packed, wall-to-wall people, I mean, literally. There you are. I was looking for you when I was singing the song. Good to see you, sitting right there in front of me. Anyway, the train can be packed, and everybody's packed in like sardines, literally. Those of you who have been to New York know what I'm talking about. And I remember there were occasions where I would be walking through the train, and all of a sudden I get to a car that is completely empty. You open the door, and all of a sudden the smell is so strong. And you realize it's a homeless person that has been sleeping in the car. And nobody wants to travel in that train. No one wants to be in that car. So they'll sit all squeezed up together rather than go into the next car where the smell is really bad because this person hasn't probably had a bath in months. Well, as I was praying some time back, I asked the Lord, and I said, Father, I want a closer walk with You, and I feel like something is missing. What is it? And the thought that God gave me was, sometimes when you ask God for things and He answers you, sometimes it's a little hard. You don't necessarily want to hear it. But He told me, you don't love me enough. And that's like, oh, ouch, you know? But I want to. And He said to me, He reminded me of those experiences where I would walk through the train and the car smells so bad, and I would walk through and get out as quickly as I could because it was really very bad. But the Lord showed me, He said, those are My children too. And Jesus wasn't afraid to touch the leper. He wasn't afraid to touch anybody. Sometimes we need the touch. God, we are His hands. We are His feet. And He wants us to reach out and touch. It's easy to touch those that are lovely. It's easy to touch those that smell good. But can we be like Jesus and touch the unlovely and remind them that there's a God that loves them and cares for them as well and has an answer for them? And the Lord said to me, when you can touch the unlovely, the smelly, that's when you'll start doing what Jesus has called you to do. So this song is about a violin that was once really a nice piece of work, and the person that owned it didn't take care of it. And so it finds itself now in an auction. It's being auctioned off. You know, do they have auctions here in this country?
Yeah.
It's being auctioned, and Everybody thinks it's just, it's not worth much. But it so happens that the master happened to be in the crowd that day. And he goes and he picks up the violin and he tunes it. And the sound that comes out that people realize, it was a touch of the master saying, this is a really valuable piece of work. It just needed the proper touch. So as we go through our Christian walk, and God gives you opportunities, remember this song. Remember what God is calling us to. Well, the air was hot and the people stood around as the sun was setting low. From the back of the crowd, a gray-haired man came forward and picked up the bow. He wiped the dust from the old violin, then he tightened up the string. And then he played out a melody pure and sweet, sweet as the angels sing. And the music stopped, and the auctioneer, with a voice that was quiet and low, he said, now what am I paid for this old violin? Then he held it up with a bow. And then he cried, one, give me 1,000, two, make it two. Only 2,000, who make it three? 3,000 twice, you know that's a good price. Who's gonna bid for me? And the people cried out, what may the change, we don't understand. Then the auctioneer stopped, and he said with a smile, it was the touch of the master's hand. Well, you know, there's many a man with his life out of tune, battered and scarred with sin. And he's auctioned cheap to a thankless world. much like that old violin. But then the master comes and that foolish cry, they never understand the worth of a soul and the change that is wrought by the touch of the master's hand. But can he cry at one, give me 1,000, who will make it two? Only 2,000, who will make it three? 3,000 twice, you know that's a good price. Who's gonna bid for me? And the people cried out, what made the change? We don't understand. Then the auctioneer stopped and he said with a smile, it was the touch of the master's hand. It was the touch of the master's hand. The roses, the lilies, the pinks, think of the joys in your life. The briars will wound you, the thorns only grieve. So gather the roses, the lilies, the pinks. As I was walking way of life, trials were all I could see. The joy and the peace I once knew with the Lord seemed like a faint memory. I dreamed that I walked through a garden fair, gathering up sweet flowers red, and stung by the thorns as I strayed from the path, I heard a voice speak soft and clear. Gather the roses, the lilies, the pinks. Think of the joys in your life. The briars will wound you, the thorns only grieve. So gather the roses, the lilies, the pinks. Don't gather the unpleasant times in your past. Don't mourn them and talk them all through. Remember the blessings God gives you on each day. Oh, listen, He says to you. Gather the roses, the lilies, the pinks. Think of the joys in your life. The briars will wound you, the thorns only grieve. So gather the roses, the lilies, the pinks.